Good morning to all. Conventional speed control methods of DC drives. It is a topic now we are going to know. In this video lecture, student can understand clearly about speed control methods of DC shunt and series motor. Also, they can know the details of Ward-Leonard control method. Let us know about speed control method of DC shunt motor. For that, students should know about the speed equation. That is, N is equal to V minus IARA divided by Z phi into A by P. In this equation, A is parallel path, P is number of poles, Z is number of armature conductors. All are constant. So, equation number 1 is modified like N is equal to K into V minus IARA whole divided by phi. Here, applied voltage V, armature current IA, armature resistance RA and the flux are variables. Again, we can get the relationship between speed and back EMF. That is, N is proportional to EB by phi. Here, speed is directly proportional to back EMF and inversely proportional to flux. From the above equation, three methods of speed controls are possible. First one, armature control. Next one, flux control method. Last one, voltage control method. For DC series motor, armature voltage control method is one of the method. Flux control method is achieved in four ways: field diverter method, armature diverter method, tapped field control and paralleling field coils. Let us know about armature control method in DC shunt motor. A variable resistance R is connected in series with the armature circuit. Here the input voltage V is constant. The speed of the motor can be controlled by varying the resistor R. So the speed equation becomes N is equal to K into V minus IA of RA plus R whole divided by phi. Look at the speed torque character of armature control method. N naught is no load speed. By increasing the controller resistance R, the potential drop across the armature is decreased. Therefore, the motor speed also decreases. This method of speed control is applicable only for speed lower than no load speed. Simple method of speed control is the main advantage. Disadvantages are, first one, more power is wasted in the controller resistance, hence this method is highly inefficient. Second one, change in speed with the change in load becomes large. Then field control method of DC shunt motor. Here, rheostat is connected in series with the field coil. The speed is inversely proportional to flux, that is N is proportional to 1 by 5. Look at the graph, that is speed torque relationship. The dotted line shows base speed. By varying the flux, the motor speed can be varied. The flux of DC motor can be changed by changing the field current I shunt. The motor speed can be increased by decreasing the flux. This method of speed control can be used for increasing the speed of the motor above its rated speed. Now, armature control method of DC series motor. Armature coil and field coil are connected already in series. Now, external resistor R also connected in series with this connection. A variable resistance is connected in series with armature. By varying the resistance, the voltage applied across the terminal can be decreased. So, it is speed torque relationship. By reducing the voltage across the armature, the motor speed also decreases because the applied voltage is directly proportional to the speed. N is proportional to EB, already we know. Also, we have to know that back EMF is directly proportional to supply voltage. From these two relationship, N is proportional to V. It is a new term we have to understand, that N is proportional to V, that is speed is proportional to applied voltage. Students should note that full motor current passes through this resistance. Due to this, more power loss occurs in this resistance. Now, field control method of DC series motor. Let us take the first one, field diverter method. Here the diverter is connected across series field winding. Field diverter means a variable resistance is connected across the series field winding. By varying the resistance, the current flowing through the series field changes. Now, armature diverter method. In this method, a variable resistance is connected across the armature. This method of control gives speeds lower than the normal speed. Third one is tapped field control. The speed of the motor is controlled by variation of the number of field turns. It is used in electric traction. And the last one is paralleling of field coils. In this method, speed control is achieved by rearranging the field coils. Mainly, it is used in fan motors. This method is mainly used in fan motors. See how the field coils are splitted. In the next diagram, that splitted field coils are connected in parallel. In the last diagram, the external variable rheostat is connected across the paralleling of field coils. Let us know about Ward-Leonard control system. The system is introduced in 1890s. It is mainly used where very sensitive speed is required, as for electric excavators, elevators, and the main drives in steel mills and paper mills. Look at the diagram. It consists of three DC machines, M1, M2, G. There are two DC motors and one DC generator. The system uses a motor generator set, MG set. The DC drive motor M1 is the main motor. It is directly coupled to the DC generator. DC supply is given to the armature terminal as well as shunt field winding. All the terminals of the machines, they are armature terminals and the field coil terminals. Supply to all these terminals taken from DC bus. Now the operation. The MG set runs at constant speed. MG set means motor generator set. The voltage of the generator can be varied from 0 to maximum value by means of its field regulator. The generator DC is fed to the controlled DC motor. Yes. Output energy of motor M1 is mechanical energy, that is applied to the generator, which is mechanically coupled with the M1. That generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Now, electrical energy of generator G is applied to motor M2, that is controlled DC motor. The M2 rotation can be changed by reversing the direction of the field current of generator G. It is done by reversing the switch S or S, and the generated voltage can be reversed and the motor rotates in reverse direction. Now look at the graph. In x-axis we have taken speed, in y-axis we have taken torque and horsepower. It combines both armature and flux control method. The armature voltage control can be achieved by varying the field of DC generator. Look at the diagram. The armature voltage control can be achieved by varying the field of DC generator. Here the field of DC generator connected. By varying field of DC generator, we can get armature voltage control method. Because the variation in the field will affect the armature supply of motor M2. Next to the flux control, it can be achieved by varying field of controlled DC motor M2. This is also M2. The flux control method can be achieved by varying the field of control DC motor. Students should understand. The Ward-Leonard system provided a constant torque as well as constant horsepower. In the constant torque mode, the field flux of M2 is kept constant and the armature voltage is controlled. In the constant power mode, the armature voltage is kept constant and the field current is controlled. Full forward and reverse speed can be achieved. A wide range of speed control is possible. Short time overload capacity is large. These are all considered as advantages. But it consists of lot of disadvantages. First one, cost of the system. Next one, overall efficiency is low. And the third one, costly foundation and a large amount of space is required. Fourth drawback is drive produces noise. And the last drawback, it requires frequent maintenance. So dear students, Ward-Leonard control method is very, very important. Thank you all.